News at 5.
A woman in Westmoreland County is paralyzed with fear tonight after being stabbed repeatedly with a hypodermic needle. Good evening, I'm Wendy Bell.
I'm Andrew Stocky. Police say she was mugged outside a Scottsdale drugstore. Channel 4 Action News, Westmoreland County Bureau Chief Jennifer Mealy, live tonight. Jen.
Well, Andrew, we spoke to the victim today about her terrifying experience being mugged with a hypodermic needle. Now, she is terrified that she may be in danger, so she asked us to hide her face and change her voice.
And she started stabbing me when I looked, and she had a hypodermic needle. And she just kept stabbing and stabbing, and they just laughed. And I heard somebody laughing from inside the van because they had the door open.
What happened outside the Rite Aid in Scottsdale has police on the move hunting for two women in a rust-colored van. The victim, who is in her 60s, was on her way to the bank at 8:30 Monday morning when she says the women in that van drove up behind her and encouraged her to pull over.
I thought then, I have a flat tire or there's something the matter with the back of my car. So I went around and pulled into Rite Aid.
That's when she says a rather unusual suspect approached her. A 6'5", 250-pound ash blonde woman got out of the van and started walking towards her.
The only words that I ever heard her say to me was, where's your money? And I just thought she was kidding. I said, I don't have any.
That's when the attack began. Her head was slammed into the car, her nose was nearly broken, and she was stabbed repeatedly in the upper left arm. Afterwards, she drove to a nearby funeral home for help and was rushed to the hospital.
They tested me for HIV and hepatitis. They don't think that there was any drugs in the needle, but they do think that maybe it was a used needle. And I thought she only hit me like three times, but they counted that there was like seven puncture wounds. And it's just the waiting.
Now, doctors are hoping for the best when her blood work comes back in 2 days. And what they're really thinking is that because the needle had to pass from between her jacket and her shirt before it hit her arm, that may have wiped the needle clean. Reporting live in Westmoreland County, I'm Jennifer Mealy, Channel 4 Action News.